This is DCU FM Monday.
Miru, tell us about what is actually going on with the radio station.
What's happened so far? Like?
Yeah.
Well, so far it was a hard process since September. We had to join the Media Production Society, and DCU FM hasn't been up and running in a couple of years. We came in, the place was a mess. It took us about 2 days to put all the equipment and stuff back together. Then we had to apply for our grant app, and we got approved for an antenna and a transmitter and a brand new radio desk and a lot of other stuff, which won't come into effect the next semester because we still have to wait for it to be delivered and installed, and we have to apply for a BCI license so we can broadcast on a frequency and stuff like that. And we have to apply to the IMRO and stuff for royalties, paying royalties so we can play music as well, like all copyright and stuff like that. So we applied to have it online and it didn't happen, but next year we'll have it on a frequency and stuff, you know.
Yeah.
And I hear that we're going to try and make this a society. DCUFM Society.
I'm looking into that. I'm separate from the MPS kind of thing. Like,
yeah.
I'm looking into that at the moment.
Yeah. You know, so if you're interested, get being interested in stuff.
We need 20 members to start it off, and then it'll be huge. It will be huge. I know it will. You know.
Yeah, it will.
So.
Yeah, would.
All us wannabe radio DJs. Of course it will.
Yeah. DCUFM.
Anyway, so Chris made a very rude comment about Emma Bunton during the break there, which isn't very nice.
No, it's true, but I'm just calling a spade. She looked very, very fat in that video. She really did. The white does not do anything for her at all, really.
The white coat.
It was a white. Was she not wearing all white, no?
I think she was wearing all with beautiful platform white boots, which were stunning.
She just looked, not fat, but pleasantly kind of plump.
Is it possible she's pregnant?
You just said she looked really fat. I'm just not into that at all, actually.
No, I'm sorry.
Can I just ask though, she might look really fat, but did she look pretty?
Oh, she's gorgeous, yeah.
Yeah. Definitely so was it really necessary to mention the fat thing at all?
No.
It wasn't. Do you feel bad about yourself? See,
no, because I said it off air and you decided to say it on air. So I don't really feel that bad.
What happens in studio stays in studio.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I just think she's looking well. She's doing her thing.
Yeah. I think we should have had the Spice Girls here for Ragball, I think.
Yeah. Oh my God, I would love that.
Yeah.
I'd actually have a heart attack. DCUFM.
Can we talk about something that's more relevant? Tuesday, €3 drinks is gone. Now, what do you think about that?
I think that someone is like trying to spoil the whole like, you know, fun side.
Students.
And, you know, like
yeah. Bring back the old bar, I say.
Yeah. Right, they're going to destroy clubs and socks and they're going to destroy our bar. So what's left, you know what I mean? Like,
where is
the community that is supposed to be in college and meeting people and stuff?
All so actually, the first week I was here in orientation week, they had presentations on the Helix and they were actually encouraging you to have a social life as well as a study life, because if you just have a study life,
social life is a very important aspect of college. Yeah. I think it's all about meeting people and
it's balancing
new
things
experiences and stuff.
So the student bar is going to be empty next month.
And it was the only good thing about the new bar. But if they open the old bar, do you reckon that a lot of people, like without the €3 drinks, will actually go?
Well, I'm first year, but what I've been told is that the old bar was just a business. It was like a real kind of homely pub kind of thing.
Yeah,
it was always packed every Tuesday.
Yeah. And what about the rest of the week, Aiden?
It's kind of dead, but Tuesday's made up for it in the old bar.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. It's meant to be brilliant, like,
yeah,
you know.
And, there's a nicer atmosphere in the old bar. The new bar is kind of a pretentious looking, pretentious people. Yeah, well,
it's not a student-y kind of place. The new bar,
because it was students behind the bar in the old bar. So
yeah,
old bar was way better last year, and the music was better, and they used to have bands and stuff.
DCU FM. Someone who was here for the ragball, however,
Bewitched.
Hello, everybody. We're going to play Bewitched now. Do you like Bewitched? Woo! Okay.
All right, cool. That is brilliant.
Arlie V.
C'est la vie.
Yeah. We have a few groupies outside the studio. Yeah. Oh, man, sorry.
Oh, they're like our perfect audience.
Yeah, yeah. That's actually a good buzz on campus today. Actually, I just want to take this opportunity to announce an event next week for an MPS Tuesday, 8 o'clock in the Ober. Everybody that took part in the radio, all right, we'll be getting first priority. And then everybody else, just come along. There's free wine, free pizza. Also, two bands. Is that right, Mark? Two bands and a DJ as well. Oh, the DJ be me. I forgot about that. Lovely me.
Ooh,
you know.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Saving on the money there. Oh, yeah. Chris. Yeah, the DJ. Yeah. Okay, that's
right, you know. Anyway, Bewitched. What did you see them?
Bit of C'est la vie. I love it. We were up at the front.
Oh, yes.
Up at the front, having a laugh. Sorry, can I just say, to Adele and Kiwi, the fabulous twins from Bewitched, who were the only two that turned up, but whatever.
Yes.
That was not great value for your money. But I wanted all four here. But they looked better than any of the girls in DCU here that night.
Are you serious?
I swear to God, I was jealous. I was just like, oh my God, they're fabulous looking.
I had the Morants to go and interview all the acts from Ragball, but they were the only people that didn't get the interview.
I know, went backstage. Now McLeod was trying to get us backstage to meet Bewitched. I nearly had a heart attack, but we didn't get it.
I was like, where did they go? And he goes, oh, they just had the legging it out of the building. Like,
as if they're going to be mob, like, you know, you're a bit modest, Bewitched. You're not that brilliant.
I think that taxi was waiting on them to take them back to Finglas, like, you know, sure.
Yeah, do you know that way? Like, it's a bit, oh, right. Yeah, don't forget where you came from. We bought your CDs 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Anyway, here is Bewitched with C'est la
vie. Play a track, will we?
Yeah, we go for it.
Yeah, a bit of C'est la vie, good stuff.